Hey guys, I have a helm build for you today. It's not really a tutorial, and that brings up a question. Does anyone want to see armoring tutorials? If that would be interesting, I have so many unfinished projects and new ones in mind, so let me know if you want armor making tutorials. To make today's helm building engaging, I'm going to tell you about one of the more fascinating battles in England's history. I hope you enjoy it. On the 14th of May, 1264, Simon de Montfort, leader of the rebel barons, met the King of England on the battlefield at the town of Lewes. The conflict would come to be known as the Second Barons' War. King Henry III was largely unpopular among the baronial class, the ruling elite, for a number of reasons. Foremost, his assertion of his right to govern without consulting the barons. Instead of seeking their support and aid in political matters, they were excluded, and foreigners, mostly those with close family ties to either the king or his wife's family, were placed in prominent positions of power, made custodians of royal castles, and appointed to political offices. And after an embarrassing attempt by the king to place his second son, Edmund, on the throne in Sicily, ended in disaster, the financial failures began to compound and led to a loss of confidence in the king's rule. To curtail his powers and formally subject him to oversight by a council of lay and ecclesiastical barons, the Provisions of Oxford were drawn in 1258. Just 3 years later, however, political differences divided the council and left only Simon de Montfort insisting on the provisions being upheld. It wasn't merely a political disagreement for Simon. He was in fact married to the king's sister. Born in France with no wealth to inherit, Simon did possess a claim to the Earldom of Leicester. He was well-liked by the king and received the approval of Henry III to secretly marry his sister Eleanor in 1238, and again the barons were not consulted on such an important marriage. A year later, his hereditary title, Earl of Leicester, was recognized, though he quickly fell out of favor with the king and was effectively replaced in a political sense by other relations of the king. In the months that followed the king's reassertion of freedom from the provisions, violence escalated on both sides. The rising hostility did much to solidify the baronial faction against their king. The king's army was gathered in the customary manner. Royal writs were sent by messengers to all parts of England declaring that all who hold to him should come to Oxford where the king's army was being assembled. In the same manner, Simon used royal writs to summon those who would fight for the barons. Determining the precise size of the armies is problematic. However, it's estimated that at Lewes, perhaps 15,000 Londoners presented themselves to fight against the royal forces. What there's little disagreement about, however, is that baronial forces at Lewes were outnumbered by 4-1. The pitched battle began near dawn at the sound of the war trumpet's blast. King Henry III's son, Prince Edward, who would later be known as Edward Longshanks and the Hammer of the Scots, led the charge with the right flank of the royal army, crashing into the baronial left flank, which was comprised of inexperienced and untrained Londoners who were immediately overwhelmed. As the rebel left fled the battlefield, the baronial army crushed the royalist center and left flank. The rebels deliberately targeted the royalist leaders, driving hard towards them as though it was their primary objective. Henry's personal guards led him as they retreated back to the priory where they took refuge. Edward, Henry's son, later joined him at the priory, where they were both surrounded and captured.